Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So today is Sunday morning, and I'm heading out to have my first personal training session since surgery. So I'm a little excited, a little nervous, and just, you know, ready to get back into this and start moving again. I'm gonna share with you guys a little bit of my workout today, what we're doing, what he has me doing, and all of that fun stuff, as well as show you guys what I'm eating before and after my workouts, which is a little bit different on the weekends than during the week, since on the weekend I do work out in the morning and during the week I do work out at night. So I thought it'd be interesting to show you guys that as well as take you along for my workout. So let's get started. So we're about to head out the door, and before workouts in the morning I like to have a little bit of something in my stomach. So I'm just eating two of these little plum plot things. I always like to have a little bit of fruit in the morning on the weekends before I go work out, just to give myself a little bit of something in my stomach. So let's go. So to begin my workout, I do some light stretching just to get my body moving and warmed up. And then we always go into jumping jacks and high knees, which I have modified to work for me since jumping still kind of hurts. So I've done a step to the side and then just a knee up instead. And then we're gonna go into squats. And I just really make sure I focus on my posture and making sure I am doing everything correctly and that everything is well aligned. That way I don't get hurt and it doesn't cause my neck to kind of start hurting, which causes me headaches. So I really just focus on my posture and getting down as low as I can go. And then we end with some walking lunges. I'm gonna go all the way across to one end and then come back and go all the way across to the other side. Again, working on posture, making sure my neck is up, making sure my balance is right, and just going all the way down, getting everything loose before the workout. So to begin the workout, I am going in and out of a ladder that's on the floor, 2 feet in each box, and then I'm doing step-ups, and then I'm gonna go over the box and continue doing in and out of the ladder. You're gonna see a pattern here, and every kind of set or movement that we're doing, I'm gonna go down all the way, turn around, I'm gonna do 5 squats and then go all the way back, and I'm gonna do that same motion 2 more times after this before we get started on the next move. So now we are doing side steps, and it's quick feet, so I'm going as fast as I can, and then over the box side steps. And you can see I kind of lost my balance there a little bit, but that's okay, just keep on going, keep moving. And then I'm gonna do my 5 squats and then go back down, and then do that set 2 more times. Here my trainer Bo is explaining to me the next set of moves. I get a little confused sometimes, so he has to kind of show me over and over again, but there's just so much going on that I sometimes forget, so I'm glad he's there to help remind me and keep me on track, because there's no way I can remember all of his crazy stuff he has me do. So now we're going out and in on the ladders. then as you saw him do, I'm gonna go up on the little box, do knee raises. And then I'm gonna go back across, in and out on the other side. And then we're gonna do, of course, our 5 squats at the end. And then in and out, in and out. He really has me focus on like my speed and control. And then we're gonna do our knee raises again on this side and continue on down the ladder on the other way. Adding in some weight work. I am doing step backs with a curl. And then I'm gonna do step backs with a row, a back row. And then I'm gonna do a step back with a tricep extension. And this is really just helping open everything up and get my range of motion. I'm just using little 2-pound weights. And then I'm going to go again in and out of the ladder and add a press. I'm really trying to get a full extension in my arms since I have a hard time getting my arms all the way straight still. So I'm really just going to feel the stretch, make sure I go in and out of the ladders, and make sure my posture is still really on. And then I'm just gonna step over the box and continue on with my ladder work. We're going in and out again, but this time we are doing a curl. So every time I get into the box, I do 1 curl. And when we get to the end, it's my 5 squats, and then I continue doing the same thing, but going all the way back to the other side, doing my presses and then my curls. So then at the end, my trainer puts all of the moves and exercises together. So we start at the very beginning with in and out of the ladder, side steps on the box, and then again going all the way across on the ladder. So I am going to complete that whole circuit by putting all of those separate moves all into one movement or one exercise, run through it, and then I'm gonna do it 2 more times. So here you'll just see me doing all the moves that we did but putting it all together. So it adds to 1 round, and I'm gonna end up doing 3 full rounds of all the exercises that we did. I forgot to record this part, but we also did just a walking with my arms all the way straight. I was really trying to just work on my posture again and trying to keep my arms as straight as I could, which is still pretty hard for me to do. As you can see, my elbows have a slight bend to them, but mostly it's just posture. I'm really struggling with that, from being overweight to having all of the loose skin. It was really causing me bad posture, bad back pain, bad neck pain, like I said, headaches. So we really just try to incorporate good posture, and then again, getting my range of motion with my arms back from my skin removal surgery that I had. And after the walking, we are gonna go into cross knees, and I'm doing it on a raised platform, like the step ups, which is a lot easier for me than doing it on the floor. You can always do it on a wall or something, which puts less pressure, makes it just a little bit easier. So I'm gonna do 20 of those, 10 on each side, and then I'm going to sit down. I'm doing leg lifts, which is actually something that's really difficult for me because of all the weight that I still have on my leg from all the excess skin. It's very heavy, and my hip flexor is still pretty weak from all of that weight. So we're really working on strengthening that muscle, but it's really important to keep pushing through and strengthening that, especially when I have to have skin removal on my legs to make sure that they are nice and strong.
Nine, four, eight, nine, 30 seconds. Ah! You only gotta do it like two more times.
So no, he was not kidding. We were actually gonna do that whole full set two more times to make a total of three times of lots of fun. So I was super sweaty after this, super tired, but it felt really good. And now we're just working on, again, my range of motion, posture, which is a theme that you're gonna be seeing a lot with me, just something that I need to work on. So I'm making sure to squeeze my shoulder blades back, go all the way up, bring it all the way down and kind of squeeze, which is again helping strengthen my neck and back, which is also really weak, and then doing the range of motion in my arms. And also passing the ball back and forth is helping with my grip and strengthening my hand muscles, my finger muscles, and just holding that tight grip, which is strengthening pretty much everything. Now we're gonna be passing the ball side to side in front of my body. Again, working on range of motion and getting full extension in, as well as my grip for holding onto the ball and making sure I really open up all the way, get my arms stretched out nice and long, and then coming back in, switching and doing it again to really open everything up. And again, like always, making sure my posture is right and have the right form and everything for that.
Sweet. Let's close it out. Shake it a little bit. Let me get jumping jacks. 5 seconds. And go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Football. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Squat. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So after our workout, we decided to stop for some Starbucks. Iced, unsweetened green tea sounded really good, so we stopped for one of those before heading home. So we just got home from working out. I thought I was going to pass out or throw up like 10 times, but that's okay. It felt good to get moving and doing my exercises again, getting my body going. So one thing that stays the same is after every workout, whether it's weekend or during the week, I make a protein shake or a smoothie. Usually on the weekends, I do a smoothie, add some fruit, some ice, you know, get a good, you know, amount of protein, a delicious smoothie in. And then during the week, I usually just do protein and add water since I'm coming home and eating dinner quickly after that. Anyways, so I'm gonna show you the smoothie I'm making today. I also have a blog post where I share kind of my other protein powders too, but for right now, I am loving the protein milkshake. So I'm gonna be doing vanilla protein and strawberries and ice and get it all blended up. And then I will show you what it looks like after. So now I'm adding the protein powder, water, strawberries, and ice and blending it up. So it tastes like a strawberry milkshake now. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please make sure to give it a thumbs up. That way I can make more fitness and workout related videos. And please make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of my videos. I hope you guys have a great day and I will talk to you soon. Bye.